Kenny Williams, Queens, New York. Hey, man, it's a pleasure to be here at Brick House, man. I'm considered the OG of comedy, and that's what I'm going to do tonight. All right, you can shut it off. Yeah, thank you, brother. We didn't really need to hear you say that shit. He got that nasty, dirty uncle voice. I did it. You know, your kids getting grown. Y'all better lock that door. Hey, give it up for Laffaholics, man. This is hot. I don't think you understand where comedy has come a long way. I've been doing this 25 years. It wasn't set up like this. Yeah, I came up in the 90s. We were doing clubs that weren't conducive for fucking comedy. You know what I mean? I love Brooklyn, but Brooklyn, we were doing shows, Brooklyn cats were sitting right in the front row, they wasn't laughing at shit. Because this comedy shit, it was fucking new. So you got these niggas sitting right in the front row, thug the fuck out. Yo, son, this nigga trying to make me laugh, yo. Yo, if I giggle, I'm gonna straight murder this cat. He's trying to make me feel good inside, yo. And they never came by themselves. There's always a group of these cats that just got home, dudes. You know they just got home. These cats don't got no social skills. Yo, you always murdering cats. Let me rape this cat. I gotta look at his lips, yo. You always raping cats. I'ma lollipop this cat. That's what I go. Good night, ladies and gentlemen. You ain't gonna lollipop me in public. That's a different type of rape. I gotta go home to kids. I can't go home and I got lollipop. Why are you walking like that? Cause I got fucking lollipop. Go the fuck to sleep. The fuck y'all still doing up? Fuck, I got lollipop. Yeah, this is a nice setup. It's a nice setup. Yeah. It threw me off. I thought he was gonna do poetry. You thought any minute, and then the sun. And they look into his eyes. Black folks have grabbed hold of this poetry and changed it. Remember poetry was soft and gentle. My first experience with poetry, when I was a little kid, we had to read poems in front of the class. I still remember my first poem. I was like in the third grade, this little cat named Tyrone read this poem in front. I remember it because it was so innocent. He went in front of the class and get that no you it's not even poetry anymore. It's spoken word. These cats are angry. I didn't know. I remember my first poetry show. I sat right in the front row. I said, this shit is intense. It's always this guy. Butterfly, why the fuck you don't fly? Cause this white man got you in the cocoon to your doom. That's why the fuck you don't fly. Fly, 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 motherfucker, fly. This shit is scaring me. Somebody gonna get shot. But you know who's more angry than the men? I'm sorry, ladies. The women, they throw yours because they call it erotic poetry. So you think you're gonna hear some freaky shit. They got a little candle. See, that women create this.
Feel my pain.
Lick my clit. Suck my tit. Lick it. Lick it. Lick it. Get under the hood. Lick my clit. Lick it. I don't give a fuck, you Jamaican. Lick. You know, Jamaicans, they don't... No, 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 listen, listen! Me don't eat nothing that bleed for 4 days and walk away. I can't do it, Trevor. Trevor, I don't... No, no, no! I can't do it. I can't do it, Trevor. I don't care. I don't care how juicy. I can't do it.
Jamaican though.
I don't know. I can't do it.
So this thing changed, man. This whole comedy thing changed, but it's good. It allows grown folks to come in like myself. I can't do what I did back in. Not my whole life has changed. Yeah, I'm a married dude. 12 years. Yeah. Yeah. Had to make a decision. Man, this game has changed. These women out here acting like fucking men. They will fuck you and never call you to fuck back. The roles have changed. Now we're sitting by the phone like a bitch. Why you don't call? I was nice to them kids. Used to buy them candy. They love the candy. You go, thank you for the candy, Uncle Daddy. You the best. You know the one thing I don't miss? The one thing I don't miss, and this is the weird thing, when you're doing this, man, comedy thing, you're always in like in a single situation. We're in clubs and bars and stuff like that. So we always in that situation. I still see the same thing with cats going to the club, buying the drinks. And there's nothing wrong with cats always go, I ain't buying no drinks. You better buy drinks. I'm a married dude. I still like, hey, sweetheart, get yourself a drink. But when I was single, I always bought drinks. Because I do not like talking to women sober. When you're a single dude, when women are sober, the rejection comes in loud and clear. When she been drinking, you go, oh, because she a little fucked up. But when she's sober, that going to your soul. Hey, how you doing? Can I get you a drink? Get the fuck away from me, you ugly. Hey, wait a minute. What the fuck you drinking? Cocaine? Listen. You trying to buy you a drink? But when you buy drinks, keep it to a two-drink minimum. Don't go past two drinks. Two drinks, man, you went from tipsy to the drunk chick. And the drunk chick, you do not want to take the drunk chick anywhere. Because you are going to fucking jail. Because they don't know the rules. Any man in here, even Nasty Voice, I'll go to jail with him also. Lies in the room. I don't even know. Shut up. Sound like a pervert. But black men, we know how to sober up because we've been pulled over a lot of times. Black men turn into actors. We see a cop, we be in mid-conversation. No, I'm telling you, man. You got a cop. It's still there. Yeah, go back to sleep. All right, you're doing it too much. He gonna think we got cocaine in the car. You can't do that with the drunk chick. The drunk chick, they don't know the rules. If I got a drunk chick in my car and I see a cop coming, I don't know about anybody in here. I'm hoping she dead. I'd rather explain death than what she about to say. Cause soon as that cop license and red, no. She probably get out the car. No. He wasn't speeding. I'm in the fucking car. If he was speeding, I'll go slow down. You gonna make me spill my drink. Slow the fuck down. He wasn't even speeding. He just been drinking. He fucked up. I don't even know why he driving. Where you going? To jail, bitch. I'm going to jail. Get your drunk ass away from me. I can't do it, man. See, you know, a lot of guys always come up, I don't know how you do it, how you stay married, you know, how you stay with the same woman for, because I grew up. Takes some sort of maturity, man. And this is my fear. I don't want to be the old dude in the club. I don't want to be this dude. How many of you chicks want to help me spend my disability check? Because my SSI coming in next week. Guys cannot come to this reality that you're going to age. The same woman that you're dealing with at 25, at 35, come on, you're gonna be 60. You're gonna be 70. You know, come on, you gotta grow up. And every man ties this into the sex, just like your eyesight and your hearing, this is going to go away. Nobody wants, every man go, yo, I go all night. No, you don't. No, you don't, you 50. You don't. You don't, man. Come on, bro. I remember when I was in my 20s. Oh, I talked a lot of shit. You better hurry up and come over here. I'ma mess up your legs. Mess up your back, cause that's what I'm about. That was back in the days when I had a dick. When you had a dick, you didn't have to take him out. He came out on his own. He said, get off me, get off me, get off me. I'm ready to go out. I want to go into the darkness. He had that one eye, the vein was, he was greasy. He was like, don't touch me. Don't touch me. I need to go out. I need to go out. You get 40, 50, you now have a penis. Fuck, take him out. You gotta find him. Where are you? Come out, wherever you are, come out. A day when he come out like an old dude coming to the screen door. Who there? Who there? That's when you gotta choke the shit out. You better wake up. That's why we got Viagra. We got Bill Cosby, our dick. I'm going about the dick. I ran out of time, ladies and gentlemen. Thank y'all for hanging out with me, man.
Give it up for Kenny Williams, guys. Can I get my three comedians back out on stage? Let's get all three of them back out. I appreciate everybody coming out. Let's get Chilean Thomas, come on out. Jason Scoop, come on out. Kenny Williams, come on back out. Chilean Thomas, y'all, give it up for him. Where's Jason? We need Jason Scoop out and Kenny Williams, come on back out. This is the beginning of Laffaholics Live. This is the first show tonight. We still got another one. So please, let's clap it up for all three comedians tonight. This fucking guy's out of his mind. So welcome, man. Now that you're in New York, just loosen the pants up just a little bit. Just. There he is, Jason Scoop. Jay! We want to thank you guys for joining us for another episode of Laffaholics Live. We appreciate it on BRIC TV. Thank you guys, and good night. Okay, guys, so that's the end of the first show. So what we're going to do is we're going to take a 15-minute break. The white people that we have here, 15 minutes for you guys. But the rest of you guys, 5 minutes, get your fucking asses back over here. All right, we're gonna take a little break. Listen, I got the Laffaholics t-shirts available for sale in the lobby. Please support that if you can. I don't want none of you guys to leave because we have three more incredible comedians. You know, Rob Stapleton is here. That's my closer tonight. You do not want to miss him. We have Davey Lozado. Yes. But DVDs? Yeah. People don't have DVD players no more. Hold the fuck. Kenny's selling DVDs.
Would y'all buy a DVD?
No, this section right here, they still have DVD players.
He has two DVDs.
No, he got an 8-track player, this motherfucker.